You can start this time.
Hello, everyone.
What up?
Welcome back. It's been a little while.
Yeah, it's been a little while for Robby.
I've been busy, unfortunately. Have you guys played since?
Disney Universe?
Yeah.
God, no. No. We have not at all.
Man.
It doesn't look like we're going to play, honestly.
Oh.
Look at you guys can't see it, but it froze in the background. There we go. Okay, we're back.
I have quite a bit to talk about.
Do you?
Just because I've been watching and playing some games, and then it's been like, what, 2 weeks?
Since you've been here?
Yeah.
It's been longer than that.
Oh, man.
It's last time you're here, because I edit them and see the date stamps, was the 26th of December.
What? Was it really?
Mm-hmm.
Wow, I didn't think it was that long.
Yeah, so it's been a hot minute. My dad came over and we played Uno, and we're going to try to get trophies, and it was the worst video game version of Uno I think that's ever been created. No trophies were achieved after 3 hours, so we deleted it and removed it from the list.
It's not the same Uno game that we played on like the 360?
Mm-mm, not at all. It's terrible. You can't even do multiplayer unless you play with the cards on your phone. What? As the controller.
That's so.
And the app was broken, and they haven't fixed it. So we couldn't do multiplayer unless we did 2v2. So it was two of us, and we'd have to rotate against two computers. And you had to be on a team. And so then the rules were weird, and each round was taking like an hour plus. We're like, this is the worst thing ever.
Was it the only Uno game that they have?
Mm-hmm.
What?
Yeah. So it was really rough. But yeah, we did that, and then Tia enjoyed some Bioshock, which was pretty fun.
Bioshock is so good.
It was really good. And we had the game crash, and it never autosaved, so we had to
start all the way over.
Start all the way over. It was a good time. But today on Two Cousins, Robby and I are going to be catching up and doing some Disney Universe cleanup. We want to try to get some of those trophies that we have to replay levels for, level up some costumes, talk about stuff since we played last, and hopefully complete it so that we can
start a new game.
Yeah.
I'm so excited to start a new game.
Yeah. For real. It's like, this is enjoyable. Some levels they're not all equal. I'll put it that way.
Right. I think my least favorite is Alice in Wonderland.
Oh, for sure. Absolutely. So I think we should hear some sweet, sweet theme song, and then we'll jump right into it.
Do it.
Okay.
Yeah, I might as well. And then go to
we have two collectibles and monsters. Thankfully, none in Alice, so we can just speed run it.
Oof. You know what? Let's just do pirates and Alice and get Alice out of the way.
Okay, so we'll get the last collectible here, and then speed run the rest.
Yeah. How do we get the characters?
By beating. So remember how this is three levels?
Mm-hmm.
Each level, when we do it a second time, we get a second costume.
Oh, okay.
So we did one with Jeremy. Remember? And we were going for the no one die achievement.
Yeah.
So we've already done one of them. So I think we can start halfway through.
Oh, okay.
So we only have to do these two, and this is the one that has the collectible in it.
Oh, perfect.
So let's jump right in. So there's the new trailer got released for the Mario movie, for context for you guys in our time, and it was 35 seconds.
Right, and it was just like a. Here's a clip from the movie.
Yep. And we got to see Seth Rogen's Donkey Kong voice. And it's okay. It's all right.
It's funny when they're like, oh, do a voice for this character, and then it's just their own voice.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that's definitely a big Drew question, but I feel like that's something that they've definitely gone away from in terms of... using actual voice actors and just picking someone for their name, even though they don't necessarily bring anything to the table. You know what I mean? I'm a basketball. And you're dead.
Gosh, okay. I died twice already.
That's pretty sad.
Since we're on Mario, have you checked out some of the...
Oh, my God.
The, like, videos of the Universal Studios land?
Yeah, it's pretty cool. It opens next month, I think, right?
I thought it was... For some reason, I thought it opened, like, this week.
Oh, it might be. I mean, it is February this week, so... We could both be right.
What is cool when I was checking out the videos is those wristbands.
Yeah.
And then you have an app on your phone as like a Mario World map.
Okay.
And the things you collect as you're walking around the park or show up on the map.
And from what I've heard, they're like you use them for Mario Kart. So you'll get like a green shell that you can use on the Mario Kart ride. But can I not flip the switch or did you already do it?
I already did it.
Okay. The one thing that I don't fully understand is it sounds like that's the only ride there.
Yeah, that's like the only physical ride, and they have another one that's like an interactive ride.
What does that mean?
Like you have to like hit the things on the screen yourself.
Like a Toy Story Mania, if you will.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
But you can only go to that one if you like collect all the collectibles in the world.
Oh, interesting. It looks super cool, but I would kind of compare it to Legoland.
I've never been to Legoland.
Really?
Isn't that crazy?
Yeah, that is really weird. Considering you're from Southern California, like me, but you know, it's really cheap in comparison to the other theme park options.
Yeah. Like the first time I ever went to SeaWorld was when your dad was staying down in Carlsbad.
Oh, really?
And we went.
Why do you think that is?
I don't know. I think we were just drawn. You're
just Disney or nothing?
Yeah, or like since Six Flags was right down the street. Mm. Like, I've never been to Knott's Berry Farm.
Really?
Yeah.
Robbie's being judged off screen by everybody that's here in our live studio audience. That's crazy. I don't believe you.
Like, Universal, what Disney, happened? And...
Did you turn me gold, you monster?
I'm sorry.
You're trying to sell me? What is this?
Like, Universal, Magic Mountain, and Disneyland are the only... And now, you know, I can say SeaWorld now, but... That's it.
Like, I've been to Universal Studios Hollywood probably... Oh, is that the last collectible? Oh, thank goodness. All right, so now we can speed run the rest of this. We can just get out of here. I've been to Universal less than 10 times in California.
Yeah, I can say the same thing.
I've been to Disneyland a lot. I've been to SeaWorld maybe like 5 times.
I've been to SeaWorld twice.
Oh, that was the time we... Okay, we'll have to share that story in a second. I've been to Magic Mountain a lot, Six Flags. I've been to Knott's Berry Farm quite a few times. I haven't been there in forever, but I have gone there many times. But I think Universal's probably the one I've been to the least of the game. I'll just do it. Kill everybody. Loopy lasers! But did you go to us? Was it the SeaWorld time when I got my shoes wet?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Oh, do we just have to kill each other? Here, just let me do it. If that's all it is.
Blah.
Because we don't know if the trophy is for, like, player one has to win.
Right, right.
So I'll just do that and then I don't need to steal any more of your money. But we went to SeaWorld and, we went on one of those rapids rides, you know, where you go
it
down
was,
the thing. And
that Atlantis one.
Was that what it was?
Yeah.
And my shoes got absolutely soaked. And my socks were soaked. And I walked around for a bit in them. And then I finally took my shoes off. and they were absolutely disgusting. Just it's raisins.
Like, it's like your feet aged 80 years.
Yeah. I've never seen human skin be prunier than in that moment. And so I took them off because I was trying to dry my socks out so that I could wear them again. And they didn't have any socks at the gift shop either. So that wasn't an option. So then I walked around a theme park barefoot.
Yeah. Hour.
It was so disgusting. I still don't think my feet have recovered, and it's been like 15 years. Like, I still have to do all these foot treatments for it to try to get some of it off. But it was gross. But I can't remember if it was at SeaWorld or when we went with you to Disneyland. When we went and every water ride got you wet exclusively and like everyone else stayed dry.
Oh, it was Disneyland.
Okay. That's what I thought. Cause I remember the rapids, the Grizzly River Rapids being part of that. And like the thing would spin and we'd be going to the waterfall or whatever.
Yeah. Yeah. And for some reason,
you're
it
totally
only got
safe.
Me.
And then we'd bounce and it would just go pivot all the way around and just only you.
Oh man. I was so cold that day.
Knott's Berry Farm has some cool rides, though, and really good funnel cake.
I heard Knott's Berry Farm is really good during Halloween time.
Yeah, Knott's Scary Farm?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. True that. You should see Legoland for sure.
Yeah, Legoland would probably be sweet.
I haven't been there in a long time either. It's obviously super fun with people who are really into Legos or younger kids. Like, Drew and I went when we were really into Bionicles when those first came out.
Mm.
They had a bunch of stuff there for that, and it was really cool.
I forgot about Bionicles.
But they have...
over here.
Oh, yeah. They have like big old Lego cities and whatnot that you can go check out. And then obviously just tons of like things built out of Legos, like huge creatures or vehicles or whatever.
Yeah, that'd be cool. Imagine the person who has to, like, build them.
Well, the thing that's crazy, too, right? And I know Disneyland has to do this, too, but it's a little different, I think, because they're Legos, is especially down in Southern California, they just get beat by the sun. So the color will fade over time. And in Disneyland, they just repaint it, right?
Oh, I didn't think about that.
But you can't really do that with a Lego because then you lose the, like, brick effect. You know what I mean?
Right.
So, do they rebuild it? So, you watched The Last of Us?
I did.
Both episodes?
Both episodes. Third one's on tonight.
True that. Tia has asked me maybe 17 times. did that happen in the game? And correct me if I'm wrong, because I never actually finished the game. Wait, are you serious? Why can't I climb the ladder? There we go.
Just walk up it.
But to my memory, pretty much everything in the show has happened in the game, but the only exception is Last of Us spoilers. Fair warning. We're going to be talking about the first two episodes of Last of Us. Should have said that before. So wait 5 more seconds and then I'm going to say
spoiler alert.
Like right away. I think the only difference is how Tess dies, right? So far.
Yeah, the people, it's not military people that kill her. It's not like the policing.
Yeah.
It's the zombies.
Yeah.
Or the infected.
So instead of zombies killing her, like they go in the building where they're supposed to meet the Fireflies and there's like those military whatever agents in there that have killed them and then they end up shooting her, right?
Yeah. Because regardless, she's infected in the game and in the TV show. And for the most part, it's pretty much the same. There's just they might extend on some things to give you more information.
Well, yeah, like the background stuff for how the infection started. And
yeah,
spread, right? Yeah.
But so far, I'm loving it.
Yeah, it's cool for sure. I'm excited to see how the story goes now because I have tried to play that game twice and it has glitched on me in a way that it is broken. Beyond Fix, and now I can actually see it. So.
Which is so crazy, because I think I've played that game and platinumed it like three times.
And PS3, PS4, and PS5?
PS3, then I think the PS3 remaster.
On PS4, right?
Yeah.
And then they did another one, part one, on PS5, right?
Yeah. And then...
I forgot we need the sword.
Obviously, Platinum Part 2 as well. And it also got renewed for a second season.
Two, yeah. Which makes me happy on a level... Oh, wait. Come back out. Okay. That's fine. Just ruin it. That's fine.
Sorry.
I think it's cool in a way because I know the game's long. So I was kind of concerned like how they'd have to pace it to get through the entire game in one season.
Well, the first game, I think, is doable on how they're doing it now.
You think so?
Yeah, because I think there's, what, 8 episodes?
Yeah, we've already done 2.
So, I think...
Did I get further than I thought I did?
I think they'll do all right with the first game, but Season 2, the information that they need to give you for the second game is so much.
Is that Season 2 is going to be Last of Us 2?
Yeah. They're saying that season two and season three, they might do like that's the second game. Because there's just so much.
Oh, pro gamer. All right. So, I got to the part where in the game where they meet Bill at the school.
Oh, that's coming up.
Yeah, I figured. But I was like, I didn't get that far. But we're 2 episodes in. We haven't even gotten to where I got to yet. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
That's why I thought it would have taken longer than that. You know?
Yeah.
Wow. I'm not going to lie. I know I give Drew a ton of grief, but the lag today is really, really bad.
Yeah.
There's some times where I just stop moving.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I thought you were doing that on purpose.
No. Thank you, Tia. Thank you so much.
No.
You didn't want to be a tornado?
No.
All right, ready? Here we go. Come get on the cannon.
I can't.
Oh, there we go.
But I'm excited to see Bill Offerman as Frank.
Yeah, Bill Offerman.
What's his name?
Nick. You were pretty close. It wasn't as bad as Zach Cinder. Yeah, that should be interesting. Tess was played by the actress that was the main character in Fringe, a show I really like. It was cool to see her again. See you, Rob.
Dang. The thing that they're adding in this episode that's coming up compared to the game is...
Oh, don't tell me. We'll talk about that next episode.
All right. Fair enough. But yeah, I'm really loving Game of Thrones. I'm really loving The Last of Us.
It just reminds me there's a group on YouTube, Mega64. Robbie knows of them. But there's one guy in their group that always does the same thing that you do and just like says the wrong name of whatever it is. And they're going to Comic-Con like, dude, you have to watch Severance. And he goes, okay. And he's like, I thought this was like a sci-fi show. And they're like, it is. And he's like, when does it become sci-fi? Like episode one? And he was watching Succession. Oh. And he watched like 3 seasons of it.
Actually, I did like...
oh, here, hit the thing first. Yeah.
I have watched Succession also.
Yeah.
I do like that show.
Yeah. It's just like they're both good, but they're completely different.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So hopefully this gets us gold on the world and we're done with pirates.
That'd be nice.
Yeah.
Even though we didn't really do much.
Yeah, we didn't get any stars or level up the costumes, but I don't really care.
I started and finished House of Dragon.
Oh, did you? Did you watch Game of Thrones?
No, but I also started Game of Thrones.
Oh.
And I'm on season 2.
And you finished House of the Dragon, and now you're watching Game of Thrones.
Yeah.
Okay. So what are you thinking about? How was House of the Dragon first? I haven't seen that.
I actually really liked House of the Dragon.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Are you, now that you're in season two of regular Game of Thrones, do you appreciate it more? Like, does it help with, like, backstory or, like, knowing what stuff is or the places and whatnot?
Yeah, for the most part. Just Game of Thrones has so much going on.
Yeah.
Like, there's so many families, and, like, House of Dragon is...
just the one.
Yeah,
or
you're focused on, like, the main one.
Gotcha.
But since I finished season one of Game of Thrones and I'm on season two, I'm enjoying... so far, I enjoy House of Dragon more.
Interesting. I wouldn't have predicted that. But, I mean, it kind of makes sense, right? Because... if you didn't like House of the Dragon, it's not like you would have watched Game of Thrones.
Right.
You want to bring that back?
Do I have to go back that way?
Yeah. I'm going to die. Hold on. Oh, my God. Okay, wait for it, and we'll follow behind him. Right there. Excuse me. Yeah, I don't think I have much of an intention to watch it, House of the Dragon, to be honest.
Plus, there's a time jump in House of Dragon.
Yeah, I know that. I just... Game of Thrones left a sour taste in my mouth.
Yeah.
I'm sure you've heard. Even if, like, not necessarily, like, what happens, but just... it's so, so good until a point where it is just really not.
You're like, what happened?
Yeah.
But, yeah, so far I'm enjoying Game of Thrones a lot.
Do you like Sean Bean?
Yeah. Yeah. I knew... well, it's funny because I never watched Game of Thrones when it first was out.
Uh-huh.
So I kind of know certain things that happen.
Okay.
So like I knew Sean Bean was going to die.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you knew that before because Sean Bean always dies.
Right. And he's you know, it's weird because he's not a bad guy really in this show, but he's always a bad guy in everything else. And then, doesn't Jon Snow die at some point and then come back?
Kind of, yeah.
And then, and I just figured, you know, like 80% of the people that you meet as the show goes on, they're all going to die anyway, so.
Pretty much. But that's like, oh, God. I think that was part of the fun of it, right? Is like in most shows, let's say Dexter, for example. As you're watching Dexter, at no point when he's in danger do you genuinely think they're going to kill off Dexter.
You know
what
I mean?
Like, he's got what they call plot armor. You can't kill him because he's what the show is.
Right.
But Game of Thrones, like, nobody is safe, and that's what makes it fun. Like, everything's high stakes and actually, like, really matters. Because they're not afraid to kill him off.
Right. Did you watch the new season of Dexter?
No, I didn't.
It's so good.
What would you give it out of 10?
The new season?
Yeah.
Probably an 8.
Okay, then I'm not going to watch it.
What? Why?
Drew and I had the conversation when Dexter came back. I was like, I was so disappointed with how that show ended that the new one needs to be at least a 9.5 out of 10 in reviews for me to get back on that horse.
And then I also started and finished Severance.
Nice. We'll talk about that with Drew because he just finished 2. So I don't want to get too in the weeds on that one. But honestly, like, just one of my favorite concepts in a long time.
It was surprising to see Christopher Walken.
Because
I haven't seen him in so long. What else have I watched? The Menu, that was good. I started a new show on Showtime called Your Honor with Bryan Cranston. Amazing.
Yeah.
Season 1 is amazing. Season 2 just started and it's kind of slow at the moment, but
hopefully it picks up.
Yeah.
In the complete opposite direction, Tia and I watched 30 minutes of buff Korean athletes.
Is that on Netflix?
Yeah.
Like The 100?
Yeah, yeah. We started watching it mostly because, as T and I have learned, Korea is making some quality television. Obviously, Squid Game was recent, and that was a big hit.
Right.
I love that show. But Kingdom, huh? Their editing is top tier. But Kingdom is really, really good. Even though I have zombie fatigue, I love that show. And then one of my new favorite shows of all time, The Genius, is top notch. So anyway, we decided to give this show a shot. And we didn't get that far because Oliver was napping when we started it and then he woke up. But it's 100 really athletic people, really fit, but in different ways. So some of them are like bodybuilders. Some of them are like Olympian wrestlers.
Right.
One's a cheerleader. One's just an actor. One guy's a gymnast. They're all over the board, right? And so my thought, because I have no idea yet, because we haven't gotten that far other than they introduced everybody, is it seems like they're going to do a bunch of like competitions based on different strengths. Like,
oh, okay.
Flexibility or just raw lifting power.
Right, and upper body strength.
Yeah, and see which type of physique is the best based on like who could do the best throughout all of them. But they start off, right? And they go in the first room like, okay, we're going to do our first game. And there's 100 squares and each one has a number. And they're like, step in your square. And there's 8 employees circling around. And they're all dressed like in yellow jumpsuits with masks. I was like, this is freaking Squid Game. What is this? And even one of the contestants goes, is this Squid Game? And they start the music from Squid Game. And then Oliver woke up. We had to turn it off. I was like, what happened to them? So I have no idea. I'm curious to see what actually ends up coming from that.
That's hilarious.
I went to on a work trip recently to Georgia.
Oh, how was that?
It was cool. You know, you have to go do your stuff during the day, but then you can check out like downtown or whatever.
Right.
Go eat. And anyway, on the plane ride out, they have you can just watch movies or whatever. I haven't been on an airplane in a long time. It's been since I got married, so 4 years. And I didn't know the duck quacks. Did you hear that?
Yeah.
Wait, hit the door right here. That's amazing. All right, should I do this mini game or no?
Let me get this other door.
Okay. So I log in and you connect to the plane's Wi-Fi and it's basically like a streaming service. And you can say like, oh, are you wanting to watch like Peacock or Apple TV and you just browse stuff.
Oh, that's nice.
So I finished the movie Amsterdam, which I had been halfway through for like a month and a half. It's pretty good. It was cool that it was a true story.
It was different.
Yeah. Let me win, Robbie.
Oh, yeah. But yeah, that was good.
So then I finished that movie and I was like, cool, I have enough time for another one. And I was going through and I was like, you know what? I'm going to watch. They had Nope on there.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah. So I was like, you know, I can probably watch like some of this and see if it's good. I don't have Peacock as a streaming service at home. So now I have an opportunity to watch it. So have you seen that movie?
No, but I've seen Get Out.
Okay. Same thing.
I only say that because the same director.
Yeah. Did you see his other one? Like This Is Us or Us? I can't remember which one of the two it's called. This Is Us?
Is it? I think it's Us with the girl with the scissors.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've seen that movie.
Okay. So I boot up the movie and the movie starts and it's a sitcom. A family sitcom, and they have a chimpanzee as one of the characters, and the chimpanzee, like a balloon pops, and it goes crazy and just starts murdering the cast. and I'm sitting next to a 7-year-old and he's playing Sonic the Hedgehog on his Switch, and I just slowly start turning my phone like, please don't look over. And I watched the first half of Nope, and then we landed, and the first half was so good. I was so excited. I was loving it. And I was like, I can't wait to get on the plane to finish this movie. And then on the flight back, hold on, I gotta put the key down with enough room to turn into a zombie. There we go. On the way back, I loaded up. I'm like, cool, let's finish this movie. And the last hour sucked.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I was so disappointed after all that. Really did not enjoy the second half. It really fell flat, in my opinion.
Oh, that sucks.
Yeah, it was a bummer.
And
then I watched Catch Me If You Can, because I'd never seen that before.
What?
Yeah.
With Tom Hanks and Leonardo DiCaprio?
Yeah.
Oh, that movie's so good.
It was good. I liked it. But yeah, I'd never seen it before, so.
That movie's a true story also.
Yeah.
He ends up, working for the FBI.
Yeah, it was pretty cool.
Yeah, I think the only movie I'm excited for this year is Mission Impossible.
Mm. I want to see Ant-Man. I'm going to be honest. I think Drew and I may have talked about this when we played Bioshock, but I'm kind of a little over Marvel stuff right now. The last couple things just haven't been great. And Ant-Man's kind of the, hit the arcade first. And then let's get the key before we...
Yeah. I'm in the same boat.
Ant-Man is introducing the Kang villain.
Like the Thanos guy?
Yeah, the big overall mm-hmm. thing. So it's got to be... It's got to kill it, or I'm going to be kind of over it. Here, can I have it? Thank you. So we'll see. We got a couple weeks for that. And then we'll see if it's... how good it is. But the one movie I'm excited for is 65.
65?
Yeah.
I don't know if I saw the trailer for that.
It's Adam Driver.
Okay.
And it's a horror movie.
Oh, even better.
But it's dinosaurs.
What?
Yeah. So imagine Jurassic Park, but a horror movie.
Interesting.
Like jump scare dinosaurs. Creeping in the darkness.
Is there a trailer for that?
Uh-huh.
Oh, I'm going to check that out. It's a very interesting concept.
Oh, me.
Oh.
Whatever. It's all good.
Oh, I just fell.
Just get that costume. Let's get out of here. Who is it?
Jack Sparrow?
No, we have Jack Sparrow. Is that Blackbeard? But everything else is this year. I'll see John Wick 4. I like John Wick.
John Wick, yeah.
But I hope it's really good, and I hope it's the last one. Although I was talking to someone the other day, and they're like, no, they already confirmed 5. I was like, oh, okay.
I think John Wick 4 is part 1, part 2.
Is it really?
Yeah, I think so.
There we go.
What is in part 1, part 2? You know, next I'm Fast so and Furious is part 1, part 2.
Silver trophy.
Boop, 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 boop. Did you guys watch the new Lord of the Rings show?
The show? T and I watched half of the first episode.
Was it not good?
I liked it, but I wasn't jonesing for more.
Okay. Cause
we're gold on this.
So what I was going to do was, after I finished House of Dragon, I was like, oh, maybe I should watch Lord of the Rings. And then I was like, nah, I'm going to watch Game of Thrones. Mm. And then I was talking to someone at work, and they're like, yeah, Lord of the Rings is okay. I was like, ooh.
I need one more star. Okay, we both need one more. That's kind of unfortunate. So do you want to get the last one on Stitch, and then we'll give all the rest to Alice?
Yeah.
Okay. And then we'll switch next time, and you can be Blackbeard, and I'll be...
Sounds good.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, by no means in the first half were we oh my God, this is boring or anything. It was just... it ended so it was only 30 minutes. It could get way better. It could not.
It's a prequel, right?
Yes. So this is a an interesting way to segue it, but the Lord of the Rings show was $1 billion TV show. Like, the budget was $1 billion.
What?
Isn't that crazy?
That sounds... man. When it's a show, how do you become profitable after that?
And it's... I would say, like, hey, maybe in memberships or whatever, but I feel like most of the world already is a Prime member, you know? So, like, how many more memberships are you getting?
Right.
So, I don't know. All right, here, Rob. We got your star up here. But on the opposite end of that... Here, I'll let you do it. I don't want to accidentally pick it up. T and I watched a video that has been kind of ringing in my mind lately where Hollywood has completely killed off mid-budget movies. And everything for...
Oh, it's over
movies
here.
Are either like $1 billion budget blockbusters or like here's your $20 make an indie movie.
Right.
And there's no in between anymore, because if you make your stupid expensive blockbuster and it only gets mild success, like let's say you spend $1 billion on it and you only profit like, I don't know, 300 million, it's still more than if you do like a $40 million movie that doubles its money.
Right.
So it's better to make a bad blockbuster than it is to make a really good mid-budget movie.
Yeah.
I was like, that's so depressing, because like when I was looking at the list of mid-budget movies, they're like my favorite movies. Like the Bourne movies, Oceans.
Yeah.
Some of those other ones, I can't remember the list off the top of my head, but it's like, wow, that's true. That really is a bummer. And they were saying the last one that really came out was the 2019 Knives Out. It was a mid-budget movie. It did really, really well for like critics and audience.
Mm-hmm.
And then
Netflix
Netflix bought it. So now it's just a streaming movie like all the other mid-budget.
It's so funny you say that, because I saw Knives Out in theaters like 2 weeks before it came to Netflix.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, oh, cool. And then I was looking at movies that were out last week, and I was like, oh, there's really nothing good.
Yeah.
But there was that Jonah Hill and Eddie Murphy movie that came out on Netflix on Friday, but it was in theaters.
Is that the You People one? Yeah. Or whatever? Yeah.
So it was in theaters, and I was like, oh, maybe go see that. But yeah, it's so weird. Netflix is like, hey, we can make a little bit of money if we send it to theaters for 2 weeks.
Well, the crazy thing, I don't remember the number. T, do you remember how much they paid for it? $425 million for Knives Out. But that was just for the right to publish it, not like the cost of the movies. So they're paying the budget then on top of that to actually make it.
Oh, what?
Isn't that nuts?
Yeah, it's pretty weird.
And so stuff like that isn't in theaters anymore. But like, did you see Palm Springs
on
with
Hulu?
Andy Samberg?
Yeah. Yeah.
Like that's a perfect example of a mid-budget movie. So yeah, before that, $450 million doesn't even include the budget of the movie. And then, yeah, it was for two movies, right?
Right. They're making another one.
Yeah. So the one that just came out and now another one. And I love them. They're great. I would like them to have more of a theater run than that.
Yeah.
But I understand, like, if Netflix bought it, they're not going to be like, yeah, yeah, okay. You know what I mean?
Which is, I don't know.
And I really, really wish they would get rid of the Knives Out part of the title. Like, just have Knives Out, Glass Onion, and whatever the other one.
Right. Actually, what's his name?
Ryan Johnson?
Yeah, he was like, I really hated that they made me put Knives Out in the title.
Yeah, I agree on that. It's just dumb.
I maybe because people, maybe if it just said Glass Onion, they wouldn't think of it as a sequel.
Yeah, but it's kind of insulting your intelligence as a viewer, you know, when you can just see the trailer or a poster and be like, oh, that's Daniel Craig from that other Knives Out movie.
Right.
I think we got to go in the drain over here. There's the button to... There we go. I'm going to grab it. But yeah, the newest one was really good.
Yeah, I enjoyed it.
All right, I got a story for you. I don't know if you read it. Did you hear about the fish that committed credit card theft?
No.
So there's a guy that streams video games, and his fish plays the games. Here, we can just get out of here, by the way.
His fish plays the games.
Yes. So the fish is set up in a tank, and it can swim to different squares, and that makes the computer press that button. So
okay.
He can swim to the up button, the A button, whatever. He plays Nintendo Switch games, and he was playing Pokemon Violet, and he was playing the game, and it crashed. And the guy was asleep or at work or whatever. He wasn't there. So the fish is on the main menu of the Switch. It goes to the Nintendo eShop, and the guy's credit card info is saved, so it just starts buying stuff in the shop. It bought like a Nintendo Switch Sports profile avatar, a Nintendo 64 emulator, and something else. I guess because it was all recorded, he was able to send it to Nintendo to get a refund. But I just thought it was really funny.
Man, as Nintendo, I'd be like, look, we'll refund you, but that's just so funny. You can just keep everything that you bought.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm curious how the Fallout show is going to be.
They're making a Fallout show?
Yeah, Amazon's doing it.
Huh.
And I didn't know that. Walton Goggins is in it.
Being what?
I don't know. I think he plays one of the main characters.
Interesting.
Your vault guy.
Which Fallout?
I think they're basing it off of 3.
Mm. That's my favorite one, so that's cool. When are they going to finally release the BioShock movie that was announced 45
years ago? I don't
know.
They said Netflix is in the works of it, and the guy behind it, they're trying to keep it rated R.
That's good. That's been, I feel like, in development for my entire life.
And then they're also saying...
Come back over here.
They're also saying that they're going to keep some of... man, what's his name? Gore Verbinski. Yeah. Some of his ideas.
Wayne Gretzky.
Because they liked a lot of his ideas from the first script.
Oh, yeah, for sure. I mean, when they originally said he was going to do that, I'm like, that's pretty much who I would handpick for that. So that's cool, but it's just been forever.
Yeah. Sorry. But now that Last of Us is doing so good, I think video game, like, they just set it to a whole new standard.
Yeah. Which, Drew and I were talking about this the other day, how frustrating that, like, The Last of Us is this good so far, and the Uncharted movie couldn't have been better.
Right.
Because you know that...
What?
With how Last of Us is coming out right now, and Uncharted came out last summer, they were... at a point in production at the same time.
Right.
So you had to know, like, hey, this one's turning out way better than that one. Or, like, hey, this is the ideas we're going with, or, like, how faithful we're being to the source material. Like, how did that happen?
I think... I mean, because Neil Druckmann, he's kind of been part of both,
yes.
Uncharted and Last of Us, but he's also directing...
The Last of Us.
Yeah, so I don't know. Yeah. It's probably... He's like, I can't be two places at once.
Yeah, but there's still other people of equivalent...
Right.
I don't know. Here, I'm going to put this in here real quick.
But not saying, like... Uncharted was okay.
The movie?
Yeah. It wasn't, like, I... Like, the other day, I, like, fell asleep watching the movie just to fall asleep to.
To Uncharted?
Yeah.
That's the worst movie. Like, all right, you fell asleep to Tinker Tailor Soldier Spy, and that's a movie I would pick to, like, fall asleep to. Uncharted should be, like, he's freaking jumping a bus out of an airplane. How are you falling asleep to that?
I don't know, man. I can fall asleep anywhere. Remember that one time I like fell asleep on the floor at your apartment?
Yeah, which time? You did
that in Tucson.
No, I know, but you just did that a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah, Robbie fell asleep in our apartment in Tucson, just on the floor next to the blinds, like 3 inches from a dead fly or a cockroach. I can't remember, but he was just out, and Drew and I are like, what is this? One of my favorite things from a Robbie sleep perspective, though, is we set him up in the in our like guest room loft area, and we like to it was the winter. The heater's off, the windows are open, we have fans on. If it's not snowing inside, it's not cold enough for Drew and I. So it was freezing. We set up Robbie, and we're just terrible hosts. We lay him on the bed and we're like, okay, good night, and we leave. We don't offer him like a blanket or anything extra to try to keep warm in the tundra that is our place. And we come out in the morning all refreshed, and Robbie's out there with all of his clothes on, like an extra pair of jeans, his hoodie with the drawstring pulled all the way shut, which I've never seen anyone do other than to like try to be funny for a minute. And he's just there like just barely keeping it alive. I'm sure he burned like 5,000 calories that night.
It was shivering. So cold. I remember walking downstairs and it was 58 degrees in the house.
Yep.
And I could you could see your breath. I was like, oh man.
Too funny. I retroactively apologize for doing that.
No, it was all right. It was like my Harry Potter moment.
Your life under the stairs at Privet Drive. There's some good times. We here in Arizona, we get monsoons, but we also get haboobs, which are dust storms. And every once in a while, once in a blue moon, you get both. And it's like just a mud storm.
Oh, yeah.
And that was happening. And Drew and Robbie and I went outside. We just took off our shoes and our shirts and then just sprinted down the street because it was downhill. And
couldn't see anything.
No. And got back to the house. We looked like Tusken Raiders from Star Wars. Just caked in sand. Do you remember, I still have the video on my old phone when we went and played that tennis ball game.
Oh, man, I think about that every once in a while, and the fact I like died laughing.
Yeah, it was pretty great. So it was Robbie, Drew, myself, and then...
Where's the other?
You got to go up here.
I know, but I can't because someone took the clock.
Oh.
Where'd it go? It's right there next to the spoon.
Oh, is it? Oh, yeah, it is. It looked like well-placed decor. So it was me, Robbie, Drew, and then our friend Jordan, who if you watch Boarding Party, you know who that is, a.k.a. CJ. And we went down to the park.
Yeah.
They had a tennis court, and we're like, hey, let's make up a game. And the game that we came up with was, all right, so Drew's going to stand at this line, and Robbie's going to stand at this line, and... Drew's going to throw the tennis ball at Robbie and Robbie can't move. You're just trying to hit him. And if you miss Robbie, then Drew at his next time would have to stand up at the net instead.
So yeah, but
punished.
Turned around.
Turned so your back's facing them. So
right.
They can just bean you in the back from a lot closer of a distance. Then let's say you miss again. Then you have to face forward.
Yeah.
So we were just beating each other, just being needlessly violent to each other. And Drew got into one of those scenarios where he had missed twice and he had to stand at the net facing forward. And Jordan was the one throwing the ball and he beat him square in the head. Like, just... right straight center forehead, like it could not have been better aimed, and it just made this knock of a noise like you'd hit a plank of wood. And I had filmed it, and then you just hear Robbie in the background just cackling, and I pan over to him and he's literally on the floor rolling around because he can't contain his laughter.
It was so funny.
It's pretty great. We did that a couple times, but I don't think anything ever topped that moment.
My other favorite, though, is...
Oh, you spoon.
You were like, hey, or I don't know how it came up, but I was like, hey, let me hold on to the side of your car while I stay on the skateboard.
Yeah. I could easily see that being your idea or my idea or both of our ideas. But yeah, I don't remember specifically either. Continue, though.
But it was it was terrifying. Uh-huh. The fact we started at one end of the street and we went as long. I mean, we went halfway, but you're already at like 30 miles per hour. And
Robbie was hanging onto my rear view mirror or my side mirror on a skateboard while I towed him with a car.
I think
over here.
Gosh, I'm a donut.
And I was just towing him, and I asked him ahead of time. I was like, "Hey, what's your comfort level as far as speed?" And Robbie's like, "I don't think I want to go more than 15." So I got to like 5. I was like, "You good? Yeah." We get to 10. You good? Yeah, I'm good. We get to 15. You good? Yeah, I've got some big speed wobbles, but yeah, I'm good. I was like, you want to go to 20? He's like, I don't know, man. And I was like, okay, you're at 20. And he's like, okay, don't go any faster. My legs are shaking like crazy. Is there something over here I got to grab?
We got to blow that teapot up, right?
Okay. Let me go grab the clock. And I was like, okay, sounds good. You're at 25. I pushed it. I mean, I could tell that he was in a pretty good spot, as in, like, he wasn't just going to completely eat it. Here, really hit that for me.
But it was fun. But, yeah, 30. Once you got 35, I had to jump off and, like, run to slow myself down.
Yeah. It was impressive. Do you still – when's the last time you slept with your shoes on?
It's been a long time.
Okay. Robbie used to do that and he used to freak us out.
Well, I had, for a long time, I had a problem like taking my shoes off in the house.
Uh-huh.
Because I just felt weird.
Like, what do you mean? Like, you thought your feet were weird?
No, I just didn't.
You thought your feet smelled? what was the concern?
No, I just didn't feel right not having shoes on. Like, I needed shoes on.
Like, they were, you just couldn't have naked feet? Like,
yeah.
Even with socks on, it wasn't good enough?
No, it just wasn't. I needed shoes on. Like, I felt like something was missing, so I needed the shoes.
So did you sleep with them on all the time?
No. Just, like, when it was time for bed, shoes came off.
But that's it?
That's it.
Like, you're like that movie where the guy gets out of bed and the slippers are right there at the side of the
yeah,
bed.
Yeah, yeah.
Just put them on.
I just had full-on tennis shoes right there.
Yeah. Yeah, there were a couple times I remember, like, Robbie would just be passed out sleeping and be like, he has his shoes on. Who sleeps with shoes on?
Yeah, there was a lot of questionable things growing up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know what I told T about the other day?
Oh, man.
You're going to love that this is on the internet. So one day... I don't remember the context for the like very beginning of this, but Robbie had brought someone home, a girl, and they were hanging out in his room. And then he had...
Is this when I went to work?
Yeah. And so he had to do a full 8-hour day when he worked at Best Buy. And he left her shut in the room. The door was shut. And... Everyone else is there at my house and we're like, is there someone in that room? And then at one point she musters up the courage to just go to the bathroom, and she sneaks out and she goes to the bathroom. Like, oh yeah, there's someone in his room. And we're like, how weird. Like, I would think if it were me, right, I would just be like, hey, I have to do an 8-hour work day, why don't you just go home and we'll catch up later, right? But no, not Robbie. He goes, wait for me here. And then this poor girl stuck in there for 8 whole hours. Robbie finishes his shift, and then he texts me. He goes, do you want to go to lunch? I was like, no, I don't. But you know who does? the poor girl who's been stuck in here for 8 hours. I'm sure she'd be happy to do anything to get out of here.
I forgot about that.
She didn't.
Where do we take this? Where's the spoon?
Up there. I see it. It's up there. We need the clock. I see it. The only time I like really gave you grief that I regret, and not, I'm going to be cold here, and not because I feel bad for Robby, but because I feel bad for my dad, was when we had made plans we were all going to watch E3 together, and we had like set everything up and we were going to like do all this stuff. And then at the last minute, Robby bailed on us to go babysit someone's kid. And we're like, are you kidding me? And so he went and did that for like 4 days, like the whole duration of it. And then we decked out his room because it was Father's Day. And we're like, happy Father's Day. And we made like 30... Father's Day cards.
I remember walking in and it was like ceiling,
yeah,
like wall to wall ceiling, just yeah, full of like handmade cards.
Yeah, and we did put some on the ceiling that Robby didn't see until he went to bed. We just heard at night. He's like, "You got to be kidding me!" And he had to get a chair and take him off the roof. And my favorite one was, "Hey, my favorite movie is Fast and Furious 6. Let me watch your kids." And we thought it was funny and we had a good time doing it. And then my dad was like, you did so much more for Robby this year than you did for me. And he's not even a dad. And I felt so bad. I felt so bad.
Oh, man. What was the last like Pixar movie you watched?
Buzz Lightyear.
Did you like it?
Huh? Oh, yeah. Turning Red, technically. We watched both of those within a couple weeks span. I liked Buzz Lightyear. I thought it was cool. Turning Red was pretty good, too. It was like Turning Red was cute for what it was, and I would have liked it more if it wasn't a Pixar movie. Because like when I watch a Pixar movie now, like my bar is so high, you know?
Yeah.
Like I expect it to just be amazing. And so when it's only great, it seems like a disappointment. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Which shouldn't be how it is, but I just can't help it. Did you see either of those?
No.
So I subjected you to it before the show. But a lot of you out there may know there were multiple Pinocchio movies last year. But a lot of people say, yeah, the Disney one with Tom Hanks and Guillermo del Toro's stop motion one. And you'd be correct. But there is, in fact, a third Pinocchio movie from last year. And it's Pauly Shore's Pinocchio. And I'm not joking. And Pauly Shore plays Pinocchio. John Heder from Napoleon Dynamite plays his horse. And I don't think Pauly Shore put any effort into not sounding like himself. So you just have this puppet of a boy who looks like a human still, God, just with a wood texture, right? Would you guys agree to that?
Yeah.
Like he's not a puppet at all. He hit the button for me. Okay, I'll just die.
I'm trying to...
So, it's this human boy with just a wooden texture on it, and with Pauly Shore's voice. So this guy's like, I will call you Pinocchio. And he's like, I love you, Dad. Like, or whatever. I can't do a Pauly Shore impression. But it's so off-putting and not at all... what's the word I'm looking for? Like meshed well with the rest of the world and the other characters. And it's just the goofiest thing.
Yeah. That trailer was pretty bad.
Yeah, it was rough.
Are you gonna... Oh, I gotta wait. What are you doing? I'm a Jack in the Box.
Oh, so you thought they were gonna like gym tan laundry and... Jesus. But I watched a thing that was kind of comparing the different Pinocchio movies and I was laughing because it's something that I don't think I would have noticed just watching the movie, but there's a scene. Did you watch the Disney one, the live action one?
No.
Okay. I didn't either, but there's a scene where they're running away from Monstro, the whale, and Tom Hanks is on a piece of wood, and Pinocchio is literally kicking his legs to move the raft to the shore. Very, very similar to Dash and the Incredibles. Like, he's kicking his legs that fast, and they're going, like, 50 miles an hour.
Oh, okay.
And I was like, this is so weird looking.
Where have I seen this before?
That I can't... Like, it's such a weird thing that I can't believe that that was approved in storyboards. I don't know if that's part of the original Pinocchio. But everything about that scene, because it's Pinocchio kicking his legs at 100 miles an hour. We've got Jiminy Cricket hanging on with his umbrella and Geppetto laying in the thing. Everything is CG in this scene except for Tom Hanks. So everything is CG. All of it. The water, everything. And it's splashing up and hitting them all. But because the water is fake and Tom Hanks is real, he doesn't get wet. So it's just this really bizarre thing where when you notice it happening, you're like, oh, what the heck? And the water's just rushing up over him and it like goes away and he's completely dry.
That's I need the hat. That's weird.
What was your favorite movie last year?
Last year?
Yeah.
Ooh. I don't know.
No? Ours was Bullet Train.
Oh, I did finally watch that. That was good.
You liked it?
Yeah.
Someone at work watched it because they heard it was our movie of the year and they could only watch. They said they got 15 to 20 minutes in and then they got bored.
What?
And I was like, I don't remember the first 15, 20 minutes that well, but should watch a little bit more because it's definitely not boring. I like the Thomas the Tank Engine guy.
Yeah. What was the bad guy? Like, are you a Thomas or are you a...
A Diesel?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was pretty funny.
I thought it was fun. I liked the water bottle scene.
Oh, yeah.
That was good. Our other top runners were Top Gun.
Oh, Top Gun was so good. I think Top Gun might have been my favorite.
Yeah. The other one that was kind of a sleeper hit was... See How They Run.
See How They Run?
Yeah. It was Sam Rockwell.
Where's the thing for this? Oh, we gotta hit the targets.
Oh. We done goofed. See How They Run was Sam Rockwell, and it was a... Like Agatha Christie.
Oh, like detective movie, right?
Yeah.
Noir. Yeah, yeah.
Kind of. But it was more of like a comedy.
Comedy,
too.
Yeah. I did like that one, too.
Oh, you saw it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yeah, I did.
It's like, See How They Run.
We kind of just saw it on a whim. We were like, this might be kind of cool. And my parents had seen it, and they're like, oh, we actually saw that, and we don't remember anything about it. And we're like, okay, maybe it's not that good. And I was like, you know, I kind of want to just give it a shot, though. And we did, and I liked it.
Oh,
it's up to you, Robbie. You got 10 seconds.
I haven't.
You got 10 seconds.
Mentioned it, but...
But you're going to win?
Yeah.
Okay.
I platinumed the reboot for Modern Warfare.
Yeah.
So that's done. I also platinumed Left 4 Dead. Or not Left 4 Dead. Back 4 Blood. So I finished that. So
out for fun.
I'm currently 25 hours in God of War Ragnarok.
Nice.
And it is amazing. So that's now cool. I'm like, I kind of want to get the Dead Space reboot.
Mm.
But I haven't decided yet because Harry Potter comes out.
2 weeks.
2 weeks.
Yeah, that's why Robbie and I are diligently trying to complete this game so we can play Harry Potter.
But everything that I've been seeing on the last week or two,
mm-hmm.
Man, this game looks awesome.
Right? I'm trying to like... attempt to curb my expectations a little bit.
I know.
Like, they keep showing really cool stuff, and it looks well done. So I don't know what to do other than get excited.
Yeah. They're making it really difficult to be like, just kidding, there's microtransactions.
Yeah, right? I'm hoping that doesn't happen, but why do we have silver?
I don't think we were done.
Oh, we have one more to do?
No, like, I think you... We had one more to do on that last one.
No, it was done. That was it. That was the dragon. We got the Mad Hatter.
I don't know.
That's horrifying.
Go purchase some characters and then come back to it. Maybe it just hasn't loaded yet.
I'm terrified.
So
I just buy the Mad Hatter.
And I even completely upgraded Mini.
Yeah. Who was I? Clue 2?
Yeah.
Okay, I didn't get anything for him. But Mini's done. All right, let's go back in. If not, I might just play it again by myself off screen later. Yeah, dude, it's still silver. We got gold, gold, and bronze. How are we bronze? We have all the things. I'm thoroughly perplexed. Anyway, Tia, can you take us to full screen, por favor?
I'm confused. It just doesn't want us to be done with Alice.
Yeah, I don't know why, but I hate it.
So what we got left? Lion King, Monsters, Inc., and Wall-E?
And Aladdin.
Oh, okay.
So if I do that off screen and then Alice is done, then we have three new worlds, and then we got to redo Monsters, Inc. still.
All right.
So
we can.
So hopefully we can wrap this up and get to Harry Potter and get our first platinum.
Yeah, I think we'll be able to do it.
Yeah. I don't doubt that we'll be able to do it. I just hope we can do it like fast.
Yeah, I think. Yeah, I'm saying like within the next 2 weeks, I think we'll be done.
Okay. That's a bold statement.
It'll happen.
Okay. You heard it here first. You heard it here first, guys. I'm going to share the text chain for next weekend when we're like, hey, let's finish this game. And Robbie's like, I haven't left work yet. Can we do it tomorrow? And then we go, okay, that's fine. And he's like, oh, sorry, I was at the Musical Instrument Museum. Can we do it next weekend? And I'm like, then Harry Potter's out. Oh, yeah, you're right. I'm busy. I'm like, what? So we'll
see. No, next Sunday or another day. During this week, we can do it.
Okay. All right.
I'm not that bad.
What? I'm not that bad? No, well, bad. And then anytime this week. Except Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, I'm busy. Saturday might work. I'll have to check and get back to you. Yeah, we'll see.
Yeah, Sunday sounds good. I can't make it Sunday.
All right. But there's that. I hope you enjoyed Robby and I just chilling out and mopping up. We had a good time sometimes. Some of it was not. But we cut it, so you didn't have to worry about it.
That should be a separate video.
What?
Just the misery of us.
Oh, us in silence commiserating over how awful that level is?
Oh,
no,
man.
Thanks. Well, go ahead. Take us out, Rob.
I took us in.
Uh-huh.
You love doing that. Till next week, Drew should be back, right?
Yeah, hopefully.
Hopefully.
I don't know.
If not, it'll just be us three again.
And we'll do Monsters, Inc. and then probably like Wall-E or something.
Yeah. And please, when I come over again, be done with Alice, please.
Yeah. Okay. I'll do that. I can do that for you.
All right. Cool. All right. Till next time. See you guys later.
Yep. Cheeseburger.